I bought a taco salad. It came in a black plastic bowl with a black plastic fork and a white paper napkin, and I threw the whole shebang out.
Hi, I'm Emily, and the last thing I bought was a chocolate chip cookie, and it was wrapped in plastic, so I threw away all that plastic from my cookie.
I bought a pair of binoculars that came in a cardboard box and were covered in plastic and had neck straps with plastic. I threw all the plastic away and I plan to reuse the box for shipping.
Hi, I'm Heather. The last thing I bought was a burrito from Chipotle. It was wrapped in tin foil and it had a plastic basket with a plastic sheet in it. So the things I threw out was the tin foil and the plastic sheet.
Hi, I'm Sam, and the last thing I bought was a glass of iced tea from Fairtrade, and I produce very little waste because I got it for here. There.
Hi, I'm John Schnelli. The last thing I bought was a gallon of skim milk. The last thing I threw away was a jug of skim milk.
My biggest pet peeve is disposable coffee mugs. Why on earth do you get a single-use cup from the coffee store for every single cup of coffee that you drink when you can, for $2, buy yourself a plastic reusable travel mug and take it with you wherever you go and fill it up? What was the last thing you bought and what did you throw away from it?
I bought a cup of coffee this afternoon from this building I'm standing in front of, and I threw away the cup.
So much of our waste stream includes things designed to be used once and then discarded. When most of the world suffers from the want of the bare necessities of life, we, Americans, are consuming and producing waste as fast as we can. The disposable coffee cup is but one glaring example of our general ignorance about the impacts our actions have on others.
So what do you do here at the union?
I am a supervisor here.
How many plastic bowls do you think you guys go through in a day?
I would say probably close to 1,000.
1,000 plastic bowls?
I would say so.
How many plastic forks?
Forks? Probably close to 1,000.
Do you know why the union wouldn't use washable silverware and bowls? Why they use the disposables?
I'm not sure. Yeah. I know it's a pain in the butt when trays don't get washed and we run out of those.
Yeah.
So I think it's more of like a easy access, quick type of thing, you know? Like if like bowls weren't washed fast enough, people get upset versus we can just run it back and grab plastic bowls.
Right.
Making cups from recycled material is no solution. Because of the difficulties in making sturdy cups with 100% recycled paper, most manufacturers still rely on up to 90% virgin material. The process of making paper cups from virgin paper results in additional water pollution, fossil fuel use, and greenhouse gas emissions. In 2006, paper cup use accounted for 4 billion gallons of wasted water, 6.5 million trees cut down, and 4.9 trillion BTUs of energy used. Some companies have implemented biodegradable cups. In the landfill ecosystem, however, the anoxic conditions prevent these cups from actually decomposing. Campuses offering reusable mugs and drink discounts have seen disposable waste decrease by as much as 30%. According to Starbucks, if 50 customers at each location used reusable mugs, we would save 150,000 cups per day, reducing waste by 1.7 million pounds of paper per year.
We need to focus on reducing our consumption first by buying less and reusing more. A reusable coffee mug is a good first step, but why not also consider bringing a reusable fork and plate with you to the cafeteria? As a campus, in addition to offering separate paper recycling bins, we should also have separate organic and biodegradable waste bins. This waste can be composted and turned back into the soil that provides our basic sustenance. As a country, we should institute penalties that induce manufacturers to reduce the amount of packaging encapsulating their products. We have journeyed so far from the roots of our sustenance that it is abstracted by fancy logos on bits of paper and plastic. Our disposable society creates heaps of trash while pursuing our wants with no concern for the ramifications. If we somehow grasp the awareness of the connection between our wants and the sullied condition we find ourselves in, we just might find our way back to a life of simple sustenance.
Bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities are Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life.